Hi, my name is Yvette, and I'm going to be your ENT examiner today. And reading the report, it sounds as if you might be dealing with a bit of congestion somewhere in your nasal passages, and that's causing quite a bit of discomfort. Have you been having any difficulties sleeping, or when you're in a certain position, do you notice that the pressure buildup is happening in one particular area when you're on your sides? Okay. Do you have any allergies that you're aware of? Any reaction to pollen? Any recent chemical exposures? Anything like that? Okay. Alright. Let's just have a look at you. Just observing your posture, areas that you tend to cater to when we're in discomfort. Okay. Do you mind leaning forward a little bit for me so that I can... Okay. I'll help you. Now in this position, do you feel any pain or anything when you're leaning forward? You do? Okay. Go ahead and get comfortable again. Okay. Do you mind if I place my hands on your throat and your neck? Okay, I want to feel your glands. I'm going to go along the back of your neck, to the back of your skull. It's a tender. Everything feels swollen. Okay. Compared to your cheeks. And now I'm gonna palpate along your nose and up into your brow here, okay? So just very light tapping. Okay. And now if I go along the outsides here, it all feels very swollen. Is there any spot in particular where this tends to be more irritating? Towards the outsides? Like right here? Okay. Gonna feel down your cheeks here towards your ears. That's it? Okay. I'm gonna place my hands a little bit firmly on your neck here. And I'm going to press inwards and I want you to swallow, please. That's tender. Okay. What about here? Can you swallow again? Now here, more towards your chest. Go ahead and swallow. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna have you do a little exercise. I'm gonna be pulling up on your brow, and I want you to try to hold your eyes closed, to squint your eyes closed. And I'm gonna feel the outsides of your eyelid here. Is that pressure uncomfortable? I mean, aside from the fact that I'm pushing on your eyes. Okay. What about up above your brow? Okay. take a look on the insides of your ears here real quick. With the otoscope, I'm going to put a little bit of air so that I can see how the tympanic membrane moves. Same on this side here. Have a restriction that's going on with that tympanic membrane, so I would normally associate that with swelling, something that's either an ear infection or congestion that's causing that to occur. I'm going to take a look inside your eyes here real quick. This is going to be a fairly dull light, but I just want to get really close and see how the inside of your eye looks. Good. I'm going to switch out the tips on here, and I'm going to just lift up your nose a little bit and look into the back of your nostrils, if that's all right. Good. Just go ahead and take a deep breath in for me, and try your best to relax if you can. Use my pen light, and this is going to be a little bit brighter. Do you mind opening up your mouth and saying, ah? Move your tongue to the roof. Okay, back down. I'm gonna put some gloves on. I'm gonna feel around on the inside of your mouth if that's okay. go ahead and swallow. I'm going to take my thumbs and press up on the roof of your mouth just a little bit. Good. Uncomfortable? Okay. And along the back sides of your teeth. Your nose getting runny? Okay. I'll get you a tissue. Go ahead and blow your nose. Okay. In case this is a bacterial infection, which there's definitely a reaction to something, whether or not it's an agitation like a allergy, or if it is the common cold or bacterial infection, viral infection. I'm going to take a swab of the inside of your nose, if that's okay. Alright, thank you. Go ahead and breathe in for me. This might tickle. Get another one for the other side. Go ahead and breathe in. Okay. Alright, so we'll take a sample of that, and if it is something that is treatable with an antibiotic, or if it's a viral infection, sometimes we just have to let it pass, run its course, but we can get you some medications to kind of dull the symptoms a little bit. Okay. I think the majority of a problem that I can see, or at least part of the problem, is that you have quite a bit of earwax and swelling going on in the ears. What I would like to do is I'd like to do just a very thorough cleaning and to bring some of the earwax out. And hopefully that will allow some of the pressure in your head and your sinus passages and your ear passages to kind of alleviate a little bit. Okay. I have a couple of different instruments that I'll be very gentle with. I'm going to first put in some ear drops and hopefully loosen up that wax. It also is a calming agent, so it will not only break that up, but it will make your ears feel a little bit less itchy. And then I'll go in with some basic cotton swabs and some ear scoops. I have an ear cleaning kit specifically for this, and that'll allow me to effectively pull everything out. Okay. Alrighty. Let's start with, how about your left? Okay. I'm going to tilt your head to that side. Get you in a, hopefully, a comfortable position, and then we'll continue, okay? Is your head oriented okay? Do you feel comfortable enough? Why don't we tilt your head down just a little bit more, okay? I know sometimes that when the fluid gets moving and it feels like it's going down your throat, that's not pleasant. I'm going to give you a tissue in the case that you need to blow your nose. Okay. Alright. I'm going to start with some oil. Just a couple of droplets. This will be nice and cool. Yeah, sometimes it feels like it's going to be dripping out of your ear, and that's okay. Clean the outside a little bit.
You can be very gentle so that I don't cause more irritation.
That's about the extent that I can get out with cotton swabs, so I'm going to switch to my toolkit. Of tools. The first one is kind of a miniature spoon. It also has an end that you can use for breaking up something that might be stuck to the wall. And then I'll be using my precision tweezers to grab onto the material and pull out as much as I can, okay? Okay. Set that aside.
break.
Chance to kind of settle.
Okay.
I'm gonna go ahead and try to position your head in the other direction so I can get access to your right ear a little bit better. Okay. Alright, let's just go ahead. Is that a good spot for you? Okay. Let me clean off my instruments here. Manipulate your ear and move it around to help that to better navigate into the ear canal, okay?
This is really tender over here, isn't it? Okay, I'm trying to be extra gentle around that area.
Gonna take a fresh cotton swab. Try my best to clear out what I can on the outside. Okay. Just try to hold still for me if you can. That's the tender spot right there.
Okay.
I definitely think you got some swelling in your ear canals. But this
I move on to our metal instruments here. Little spoon.
Try to stay very still for me, okay? Get a lot of your wax on the side. Move on to the tweezers.
Okay. Just pull out any remaining debris.
Pull up and back on your ear just a little bit. Go back in here with the otoscope. Okay. That is looking much clearer. Just a little bit of medication on the inside of the ear that will prevent itching and hopefully reduce some of the swelling and the urge too. Yeah, I know sometimes when I've had ear infections, it takes everything in me just not to stick something into my ear because it itches so badly. So we're gonna put just a couple more drops in. Pinch your earlobe and maneuver it around. Get it to set a little bit. Okay. Okay. I think that one is ready for some relaxation. Anything else that might have exited okay? Otoscope again. We'll take a nice deep look again, okay? Okay. You do have quite a bit of swelling in that one ear. So we're going to keep a tab on it, okay? I'm going to put a little bit more medicated ear drops. And this will help to keep the ear clean and also to relax it. Maneuver the air a little bit, get it to sink in. Face me again. Just using a little bit of tissue to get any of the remaining medication that's exiting the ear. Okay. And check for your respiration real quick before I get you wrapped up here, okay? I want to check to see if there's any signs of being a respiratory problem, okay? Just breathe normally for me. Do you feel any pain in your chest? I'm gonna reach around into the back. Good. Take a deep breath in for me. And again. Go ahead, exhale. Your respiration sounds pretty good. You have a little bit of congestion, so I don't think that this is a problem stemming from an upper respiratory infection, but I'm very curious about this ear and how it response to treatment. So what we'll do is maybe in a couple of days, after the medication has some time to sink in, that we can come back and visit this and also listen to your lungs again. Okay. Okay. Do you feel any relief in your sinus cavities at all? One thing that I can do before you leave is just do a little bit of gentle palpation, and this will help to start the migration of all that mucus that gets stuck in there. That's not a pretty word to ever say, but if we can help to move it down, and that way it'll help the body to bring the swelling down and the infection can start to clear out. I'll just start by your eyes and your nose. And work my way outwards. Now, ideally, when you have any kind of sinus congestion, what you like to do is press this way down to right around your ears and then downward. And what this does is it helps to move all that fluid into your lymph system and down. And that will allow your lymphatic system to more effectively clear it out. Okay. The nose, just very gentle palpations. And I'm moving out towards the side. Right in front of the ears, down the cheeks. Down the sides of the neck. To the clavicle area. And then outward. You also have a webbing of lymphatic tissue right here, so you can also just pat your chest down like that, and the more circulation you bring to this area, you'll also notice that you'll start to get a little bit more of a running. Also above the eyes. This can also really help when you have a sinus headache due to congestion. This is something you can definitely practice in your own time, so that if you want to help free up some of that congestion, it'll definitely. Okay. We'll check up on you in a couple of days on that one side. Give me a call if it gets to be a little bit too painful. We'll see if there's anything else that we can do to alleviate that pressure, okay? Alright, take care of yourself in the meantime, okay? We'll see you in a couple of days.